an old, you know, building over there, well, you know, in
for a community-serving development with 100% affordable housing.
Yeah.
Due to the activism of mission residents and community groups, the city recently purchased the nearby site at 490 South Van Ness, just down the way at 490 South Van Ness and 16th Street, for the purpose of developing affordable apartments. Another victory that we brought to the Mission District. Plaza 16 and our allies insist the city can and must do the same for this property.
Hey, Larry.
How are you, man?
The Mission District, as we have said countless times, is in crisis. Since 2000, 10,000 residents have been displaced, including 8,000 Latinos. Our treasured art and cultural institutions, nonprofits, and mom-and-pop local businesses have been forced out due to evictions and increasing rent. SROs are being converted into tech worker housing and tourist hotels. This community is being displaced and ripped apart block by block, day by day. The answer to this crisis is, of course, to build affordable housing. And that is what we must do on the precious few suitable sites left for development in the Mission. We demand that the city do what is right and purchase the 1979 Mission property for the development of 100% affordable housing.
My daughter told me I had to tell my hair.
There are other monsters looming in the Mission, as you will find out.
There's so many monsters in the Mission. Next up, we have Gabriel Medina with Mega and Yes on Prop I.
Well, I don't know what's going to happen.
All right, this is a celebration of community planning and taking back our neighborhood. We know we see a lot of great signs here. No beasts on Bryant. No monster in the Mission.
I'm really happy that Mission Housing got
the... Yes on Prop I, love the Mission. And a coalition coming together to protect our land, our space, and really a hub of culture for the Mission, for a hub for the transgender community, a hub for the Latino community, a hub for the Chinese community, a hub for really the working class labor community at the Redstone Labor Temple. This is a hub, really, for a diverse community of working class neighborhoods, the tradition of San Francisco. And I love San Francisco. Do you love San Francisco?
Yeah.
I love San Francisco so much. I want affordable housing and not luxury condos.
I love the Mission.
Now, that's what makes San Francisco special. It's our unique neighborhood. It's our special character of the neighborhood. That means Chinatown. That means the Castro. That means North Beach, and it especially means the Mission, doesn't it? So Proposition I is already having an effect. Just being on the ballot is already having an effect of making developers know they cannot flip properties purely for profit speculation. They need to take community plans into account, and that's what Proposition I is about. It's a pause for a plan. Do we want to pause for a plan for 1979 Mission?
Yeah.
Do we want to pause for a plan for 1979 Mission?
Yeah.
Do we need a pause for a plan for the Beast on Bryant?
Yeah.
We need pauses to have a holistic, comprehensive plan of housing balance in the Mission and housing balance for every neighborhood. It's got to be specified. It can't be project by project. That's also especially important for other projects. I'm talking about the Resic building at 17th and Mission, where they're displacing 70 artists. So they can build offices for high-income employees that have not invested in our community, that are not employing our community. The Latino community in the Mission has a 20.8% unemployment rate. That's disgusting. What we've seen over since 2000, we've seen almost one-third of Latino population displaced from this neighborhood, 10,000 people displaced from this neighborhood, over 2,400 evictions from this neighborhood, and the loss of 1,400 households with children from this neighborhood. It's been pure population replacement. We've added 6,000 people that make over 100,000 a year while displacing 3,000 households that make less than 75,000 a year. We're losing our working class character. We're losing our neighborhoods. And that's why we're going to fight back. This November, Proposition I Love the Mission. You go to SaveTheMission.org. You can donate. You can volunteer. You can also come to Plaza Adelante Tuesdays at 1 p.m. 2301 Mission, 19th and Mission, and we'll help you mobilize other volunteers. If you want to have a house party, sign up. SaveTheMission.org. Proposition I Love the Mission. Affordable housing, not luxury condos. Thank you, guys.
Hi, everybody. I'm Gladys. And we are from part of Pro Eye, we love the mission. And we just want to say a little bit about what Gabriel just said, about the, what are we doing now, because we're excited about the next...
Yeah, so we need all the help we can get. Please get involved. The best thing to do would be to go to our website, which is www.savethemission.org. We need volunteers, we need money, we need to mobilize our community. So if you'd like to get involved, you can talk to either Gladys or I afterwards, or again, please go to savethemission.org.
Thank you. And also, if you go on the website, www.savethemission.org, and you donate, please, $1, $5, whatever, and share it on Facebook so other people can get motivated. And Twitter. But also, we're going to have our first mobilization this Saturday at 10 o'clock. So if you guys are free, available, and I know you are, please come on Meta. What's Meta?
Meta is just a few blocks down here, 2301 Mission Street.
10 o'clock this Saturday. We need you there, please. Thank you very much.
Tell your friends, too. Thank you. Thank you very much. Great information. All right. Next up, we have Lisa Vincenzi with Cultural Action Network.
Hey, Lisa.
And Sean Bryant. Hello, my name is Ethan. I'm from the Cultural Action Network. Thank you for coming out, everyone. I want to make sure it's clear to you that the eradication of increasingly rare art and light industrial trade shop spaces is not okay. We are finding more and more. Hundreds of art spaces have disappeared already, and more are to come if we do not change the game. I would like to read to you some of the elements of our policies that were created in Eastern neighborhoods in the Mission General and Mission Plan and the General Plan arts elements that are being abused by this Beast on Broadway. Beast on Broadway. It's going to get to Broadway if we're not careful.
Probably already is.
It already is.
Evanston Broadway also has one. So, in the Mission Area Plan land use, there's policy that says that we are continuing to protect traditional PSDR functions that need large, inexpensive spaces to operate. To retain the mission's role as an important location for production, distribution, and repair. These are policies 1.1.8, objective 1.7, objective 2.1, to ensure that a significant percentage of new housing created in the mission is affordable to people with a wide range of income. Does the Beast on Broadway do that? No. Excuse my mouth, sorry. Beast on Broadway. Objective 2.6, to increase permanently affordable housing production and availability. And community facilities. Objective 7.1, to provide essential community services and facilities. 7.1.2, recognize the value of existing facilities, including recreational and cultural facilities that support their expansion and continued use. Over 30,000 square feet of trade shop and art spaces, cultural organization spaces, are eradicated in this project. 30,000 square feet. This includes also legacy buildings. Is this okay?
No!
Not okay. It is imperative that we use a community-based process for large-scale development. Has Podell done that in any way, shape, or form?
No.
We've got the beginnings of some workings on tangible plans and moving around with stakeholders.
But we need to put a stop to this before everything gets worse.
Before it's too late.
We cannot any further allow luxury development projects nor the demolition of arts and light industry spaces until the city's reckless development, long skewed in direction of big broad business, has been brought back into a balance that serves the needs of an inclusive, diverse, and equitable San Francisco. Thank you very much.
All right.
Join us at the Cultural Action Network and Tuesday night at the Mojo Theater, 7 to 9. And also please join us September 10th. September 10th at City Hall, starting at 11 in the morning. We're going to be meeting up, but any time during the day you can join us. We will have actions going on. We will have people supporting you in being a community servant by public comment. And we need you all day long, all night long. Show up after work if you have to. Thank you very much.
September 10th is City Hall. It's the next time the mission takes over and all our allies across the city take over City Hall. We need everybody there September 10th, all day. Take a flyer so you don't forget.
All right, everybody, thank you so much. We have a couple more speakers, but we want to remind you why we're here right now. We're here because we've received encouraging news about the monster in the mission, and we just want to reiterate the power of the people and how we got to this point, because it's been 2 years fighting. And this would have been already been broken ground at this point, but we've solved it, and our community activist work together made this happen. So to anybody who said, why are you doing that? They're just going to build it anyway. This is a good proof, and I'm glad that my kids saw this from the beginning and to this part, because I'm a parent at Marshall Elementary, and this is a good learning experience for our kids, for sure. All right, so next we have Angelica Cabande with Southfield Market Community Action Network and the SOMA Action Committee speaking about the Fifth Emission Project. So let's hear it for Angelica.
Hello, Boston! How are you doing today? I'm Angelica Cabande, and I'm with the Southfield Market Community Action Network. SOMTEM educates, organizes, and mobilizes youth and families to have a healthy SOMA neighborhood, which means that we have affordable housing that's real affordable, decent jobs and living wage, and all the basic needs that we need to survive and live in San Francisco. First off, I want to raise my fist to all of you for the great work you did and demonstrating what people of power looks like when we collectively come together and fight for what you believe is right, and you fight for your community. And this show today with Maximus not being able to move forward with its development. I want to applaud all of you for flexing your people power and voicing out that the community wants a pause on luxury development in the mission.
That's right.
And I want to commend all of you for the tireless work you continue to put in, as well as build community strength all over the city. We continue to fight against the beef on violence, getting top eyes because we love the mission. And also standing in solidarity with the SOMA Action Committee to stop Forest City from supersizing the Southfield Market. The massive stock zoning and side dealing and gentrifying 5M project plans to build luxury office and residential tower as high as 470 feet. That's more than 50 feet taller than the Embarcadero Center in the heart of the Southern Market. Is that what we want in our backyard?
No!
The city has been side dealing with the developer for city for years to set up the super size height and cut the community out so they don't have to comply with the current zoning. The deal with Forest City was more than double existing zoning in this traditionally working class diverse community. If allowed to go through, it will set horrible precedents for the city, where developers and the planning department spot zone individual projects. ignoring the zoning rules developed for years with community input and land developers' pockets with huge increase in land value from supersizing their lots. This lot is owned by Hearst Real Estate, who already owns a lot of land in San Francisco. We don't need developers and landowners like Hearst and Forest City to make profit out of our people, to make profit of displacing our community. And today, along with all of you, we say no to development that will displace us, no to development that will gentrify our community. We stand in solidarity with you, and we inspire us to continue doing this in our own neighborhood. Woo! We look forward to taking back City Hall with you on September 10th as we demand our city is not for sale. As we demand accountability from Mayor Espy, and he cannot pay to play in the backs of the working class. We look forward to standing with you as we demand that our community demands are addressed and that this lot right here is owned by the people. Before I end my speech, I want to do some chats, if that's okay. Tell me what you want, what you really want. Tell me what you need, what you really need. Just say, tell me what you want, what you really want. Tell me what you need, what you really need. Tell me what you want, what you really want. Tell me what you need, what you really need. How we gonna get it? People power. How we gonna get it?
People power.
How we gonna get it?
People power.
How we gonna get it?
People power.
Tell me what you want, what you really want.
Justice.
Tell me what you need, what you really need.
Justice.
Tell me what you want, what you really want.
Justice.
Tell me what you need, what you really need.
Justice.
How we gonna get it?
People power.
How we gonna get it?
People power.
How we gonna get it?
People power.
How we gonna get it? Thank you, everyone. We stand in solidarity with you, and we look to see you on September 10th. Let's take over City Hall, not just on September 10th, but the starting is on September 10th. And from now on, this is our city. Let's protect it and make sure our people are able to live here. Because whose city is this? Whose city is this? Whose nothing is this? Thank you.
Wow. Thank you so much. That was awesome. So basically, if you need a cheat sheet, you want to check your notes, we're saying no to everything. No, no, no. But we're saying yes on Prop I. So just know that. No, no, no. Yes on Prop I. We want yes on Prop I. So thank you so much. Okay. Next, I'd like to introduce one of my personal favorite people, my two favorite people, I should say, Maria Zamudio and Gloria Esteba with Causa Justa. Give her a round of applause.
Buenas tardes, guerreros. ¿Se puede? ¿Se va a poder más? Estamos hoy festejando una de nuestras victorias. Que los que nos vieron empezar dijeron, eso no se puede. Y demostramos que sí se puede.
So we're here today celebrating a community victory. Because when we first started, people told us, you're not going to do anything. They're going to build it anyway. And look at us now.
Y es importante que me oigan los que hablan español, porque aquí debemos estar. Aquí debemos luchar, porque esta comunidad, nosotros hemos trabajado para que se pague, para que se construya y para que esté hermosa.
The Spanish speaker in this wall, because we need to be here. This is our fight, because we built this neighborhood, because we paid for this neighborhood, because we created the culture of this neighborhood. This neighborhood is ours.
Y
muchas cosas se pueden. No tenemos que equivocarnos nuevamente. Hay que votar por la I.
And there's so much more that can be done now. There is so much more that we can do in November. We have to vote for yes on Prop I.
Y démosle una sorpresa al dinero, al capital, votando por nuestro candidato, Herrera, porque este candidato es de nuestra comunidad. Es un cronista de todo lo que pasa en nuestra comunidad con su voz.
And so in November, let's surprise all those people with money. Let's surprise all those people who think they own the city because they have money and vote yes on us and vote yes for our community leader, Francisco Herrera, who is from the community, who has been with us in our fight, in our struggle. So let's make sure that we have a community win in November.
I know.
Compañeros, gracias por todo su trabajo. Gracias por todo lo que somos. Y volvense a ver. Somos guerreros y vamos a seguir haciendo. Vamos a seguir luchando. Vamos a seguir logrando que San Francisco siga siendo de nosotros. Lo vamos a seguir construyendo porque nosotros no somos huevones. Somos trabajadores.
So look around because you all are warriors. Thank yourselves, thank the person that's standing next to you because we made this happen with our struggle and our fight and we will continue to do this. We will continue to build San Francisco. We will continue to make this city great. We will continue to fight for what we believe in because we are not lazy. We are hard workers. We make things happen and we are warriors fighting for our well-being.
Y ojo, compañeros, hay que apoyar a todas las organizaciones comunitarias que están apoyando y sigamos adelante.
And also thank you to the community-based organizations that have supported us and have supported all the people that are getting displaced. Not one more displacement, not one more eviction, not one more person being kicked out of their home, not one more child in the street. We need to stop this now. This ends today. The community is ours, and we are going to put an end to this mass displacement of our people.
También a los compañeros de la prensa comunitaria. No necesitamos otras. Gracias nuestra prensa comunitaria y sigan difundiéndole a la comunidad que aquí estamos los guerreros y necesitamos más guerreros para seguir luchando por nuestro San Francisco. Gracias.
And a special thanks to our community-based media groups who have been pushing the story, who have been making the story important. When nobody wanted to cover the Blessed 16 fight, our community-based media did, and they got the message out. They got more warriors in the struggle. So thank you so much, and we keep going and we keep fighting. Thank you.
Yeah.
Gracias, Gloria and Maria. Woo! That was beautiful. Gloria's passion. Woo! Can I feel it? She is inspiration to all of us. All right, so our last and final piece that we have today to offer our beautiful people is a beautiful song by a gentleman who is a longtime cultural activist and a mayoral candidate. Let's hear it for Francisco Herrera.
All right. Let's keep going. As Gloria said right now, no one believed this could happen. They always do this line. You've heard it before. It's going to happen. So all you can negotiate is how many degrees you can bend over. Well, so that's not true. We're seeing, we're proving it. So repeat after me. We'll sing it, but first we're going to recite it. No more monsters in the mission.
No more monsters in the mission.
We don't need that ugly sight.
We don't need that ugly sight.
We need homes we can afford.
We need homes we can afford.
And for this we organize.
And for this we organize.
And I'm going to ask one of our endorsers, the famous Tommy Iacocelli, Mecca, to come and join me to sing that song together. It's got a merengue beat to it. Greetings to Father John from St. Charles. I'm glad you're here from 19th and Sultanate. No more monsters in the mission. Try it. No more monsters in the mission. We don't need that ugly sight. We don't need that ugly sight. We need homes we can afford.
We need homes we can afford.
And for this we organize. Let's get those hands.
No more monsters in them. And for this we organize. In a mission, we don't need that ugly sight. We need hungry than a fool.
For this we organize,
and for this we organize
stronger.
No more monsters in the mission. We don't need that ugly sight. We need homes we can afford.
And for this
we organize stronger. No more.
We don't need that ugly sight.
We don't need that ugly sight.
We don't need that
ugly sight.
For this we organize.
And for this we organize.
Pump us.
No more monsters in the mission. We don't need that ugly sight. We need what we
have. And for this we both provide.
For this we both provide.
Viva la
Nación!
We have Proposition I that we have to pass. Okay, so we need everyone's help with that. SaveTheMission.org. September 3rd, we're going to go to the Planning Commission. We need you there. We're going to speak against the B-Stop Bryant. We're going to speak against the 5M Project in SoMa. September 10th is the big, big day. We need everybody in City Hall on September 10th. We're going to be there all day. There's an action starting at 11, and then we're going to be there all day, and we're going to keep them
here. Yeah. I'm right there.
I did that. Sorry. Too loud to see you.
My bad. Okay, go ahead.
And then we're going to go right back on September 17th, probably back on September 24th. But September 10th, remember that day. Be in City Hall. Join us there. We've taken over City Hall twice already. We're going to do it bigger and better than we have. Prop I, thank you all for coming.
Solamente quería traducir lo que estaba diciendo Andy, porque va a ser, estamos movilizando otra vez, porque ya va a ser la tercera vez que la misión toma la alcaldía, porque la alcaldía es de nosotros y ahí es donde tenemos que hacer que nuestra voz se escuche. Así que si han visto este papel amarillo que tiene el 10 de septiembre, el 10 de septiembre va a ser la próxima vez que vamos a ir a la alcaldía. Bueno, el programa de acción va a empezar a las 11 y de ahí vamos a ir a la comisión de planificadores para decirle a los planificadores que no pueden pasar la bestia en Bryant. La bestia en Bryant se tiene que terminar, y pues de ahí vamos a seguir también abogando en contra del proyecto en la 5M, como dijo la compañera Angélica de SoMa. Así que todo septiembre vamos a estar en la alcaldía dejándoles saber a los miembros de la mesa de planificaciones y la mesa de supervisores que la ciudad es del pueblo y el pueblo tiene su voz.
Sí, en la I, sí, en la I, sí, en la I, Papa in Spanish, sí, en la I, sí, en la I, sí, en la I, estamos aquí, sí, en la I, estamos aquí, estamos aquí, estamos aquí, estamos aquí, estamos aquí, estamos aquí. All right, so one thing just to clarify what Andy was saying. September 10th at 11 a.m. 9, 10 at 11 a.m. 9, 10 at 11 a.m. Thank you, Jonathan.